This is the reality of things at the moment is that your test has been cancelled and you were maybe a week away, maybe a month away, maybe less than a week away. I can give you two examples of what's happened with my students. One of my students, I was saying to her a couple of days before a test, just keep an eye on your emails because they might get cancelled. And we turn up at test centre. Now, the test centre where I go in Bletchley, there's usually about 8 tests taking each time slot. And we turn up expecting it to be busy. And I was saying to the girl who was taking the test, now, I don't want to come inside the test centre because there's going to be lots of people in there. We turn up, no one there. it was like desert at that point. So we went inside, me and this student, and the exam had come out and there's only us there. And it says, oh, you're the lucky one today. Everyone else has been cancelled. So she took a test and she passed. Now, that's great. And she was over the moon. The next day, all tests were cancelled. And everyone went into lockdown. So she was quite lucky. And the nice thing is, about a week later, I was in Tesco shopping and I bumped into her with her husband. And she said to me, I've got a car. I'm driving round now. I'm not driving much, but I'm driving round to shop. So that's the good side of it. Now, the downside of it, like I say, I've had people who had the test cancelled. I've had people who had test cancelled a couple of days before the test. And I'm sure you're thinking, that's me as well. You know, I've had an email and it went into junk folder and I didn't realise I turned up and it was cancelled the day before. So it's happening to everyone. And if you're one of them people where it has been cancelled, or you're one of the people where your lessons have been cancelled and you're thinking, oh God, I was enjoying my lessons and I thought I'd be ready in a few months' time, it'll come along. The time will come where you'll restart your lessons, or you'll get a phone call or a text off your instructor saying to you, lessons are back on, or have you got a test date through for your new driving test slot? Because they are rebooking tests. But what you've got to say to yourself is, if you've got your test cancelled and they give you a new test and it's like 2 months away, then you're going to have to give yourself some lessons prior to your new test date, because your instructors will be very unlikely to take you for your driving test if you've not been driving for 2 months, because what's going to happen is you're going to get in the car and you're going to do something silly. So you've got to be prepared to splash a little bit of money out. I mean, you won't need many hours, I would have thought, if you're ready for your test and your instructor saying you're ready for your test and you know you're ready for your test and just got cancelled a week before, then just have a few lessons, see how it goes. You might surprise yourself and be really confident and do it all really well. Fantastic if it happens. But more than likely, what's going to happen is you're going to get a little bit nervous, make a couple of silly mistakes on your first lesson, and then second lesson, you'll be raring to get on with it. By the time you take your third lesson, you'd be probably ready for your test at that point. It's hard to say, everyone's different. If you're one of them people who've had your lessons cancelled, you'd rarely get back in that car and you think, I'm going to get rushed as anything, a lot depends on how far away, how many hours you've done on lessons. If you're right at the beginning of your lessons, then there's a good chance that you're not going to miss much because you've not done much. But if you're, say, 10, 20, 30 hours into your lessons, then you've got to keep yourself tip-top. You know, keep yourself looking at videos on different scenarios, like roundabouts or junctions or stuff on how to control that clutch. So keep yourself busy. Keep yourself looking at videos. Even pull out your highway code and remind yourself of the road signs or procedures, because what's going to happen is there's going to be a little bit of doubt creeping in. And it's the same for people taking tests. There's going to be a little bit of a, do I do this? Do I do that? You know, where you start to overthink things. Get your highway code out, read it. Do what you can to keep yourself from getting too rusty, okay? Good luck when the time comes. If you're taking your test, good luck with your test, but like I say, be prepared to take a few lessons. Don't just suddenly think you're going to swing it and just take your test, because what's probably going to happen is you're not going to pass. So do some lessons. It'll probably pay off in the long run. And if you've got your lessons coming up, look forward to them. You're going to get a bit nervous at first few lessons, but look forward to them again. Okay? Good luck, and I'm hoping this helps you. Take care.